He's looking.
Bye, baby.
बाय बाय करके
I thought there could be like a really like,
and why are you saying a boy?
What is your thought process?
This is what happened with you guys, right?
100% it's a boy. I've seen girls getting pregnant, men have pregnant, like this, it's a boy. 100%.
You've seen this fucking 4 times, so you can
think that. 3 times.
Welcome, Sanya. Well, one more addition is she's also the Goodwill Ambassador for UN Women in India and in South Asia. We are so proud of this association that was established many years ago, and we continue to have that association with Sanya. Sanya, please. Sanya and I have been on a couple of panels by now, and I always have the same questions to ask, but I'm going to ask you that again, because I think everybody deserves to know your story. From putting us on the map of tennis to taking courageous decisions in your personal professional life, and now visibly mommy to be. Well, first of all, thank you very much for having me here. Like Nisha said, UN Women and I go a few years ago actually, and it's obviously been a relationship that I probably cherish more than most other relationships I've had besides my parents, because the ideology that we have is exactly the same and what I've been taught by my parents, and that comes from UN Women to me. My story is not as funny as Tajimul, so I apologize for that. But you know, I'm not that great a storyteller, but it's a very simple story. I started playing tennis when I was 6 years old, at a time when a girl playing tennis in Hyderabad was unheard of. Where I came from, a family full of cricketers, including my dad and everybody that you name. I have, including my husband now, but and when my parents actually said, you know, she's going to play tennis. And my aunts and uncles, they were like, हाँ ठीक है खेलने जा रही है लेकिन काली हो जाएगी देखना कोई शादी नहीं करेगा. I mean, I was 6 guys, like for God's sake, right? So my parents were like, what does that mean? Like, and I come from a family of 2 girls, and that's it. So till today, even after everything that I've achieved or tried to achieve, still when people meet me and they say, आपका कोई भाई नहीं है, and I say नहीं, and they're like, अरे, and I'm like, no, that's fine. Like, it's absolutely okay, because we've never felt that need, you know, which, like ma'am was earlier saying, you know, okay, it's now I'm pregnant. And every time I meet someone, the first question is, the dua is, quote unquote, ke, oh, ladka ho jai, main dua karunga. I said, bhai, please mat karo ye dua. Ladki ho jai, dua karo. Kyun aap ladke ki dua kar rahe ho? So that is the sort of mindset that we grow up with, consciously or subconsciously. And when we come out and try to speak about it, we are labeled as feminists. And for me, that word just doesn't do it. It doesn't do it, because why is there no word for a man speaking about men's rights? Has anyone thought about that? Never. But when you speak about female rights or feminism, you're taken as a feminist. And no, I don't think I'm a feminist. I think I'm a person who deserves equal opportunity like we all do. Whether you're a man, whether you're a woman, it does not matter what gender you are. You should have equal opportunity. It doesn't matter what I can do or what a man can do. That doesn't make us equal. What makes us equal is the fact that we have the opportunity to do the same thing. So for me, that is the most important. My parents always taught me and my sister to follow our dreams, no matter how unconventional they were. Even if that meant, oh my God, wearing short skirts and playing tennis and getting dark and, you know, and risk of not ever getting married. But, and we have. My sister has become a businesswoman, which is completely different to me. And I was a tennis player. I am a tennis player. Right now I'm a mother. But, it has been a pleasure and an honor to grow up in my family. But I realized that how privileged we were to come from that family because of the amount of people in this, forget country in the world, it might be a bit more pronounced in this country, but it's all over the world. Till today, we fight for equal prize money. We have to justify why as tennis players, we should make the same prize money that the men do. So that means this inequality is everywhere in the world. It's not just in this part of the world. So I just like to say that today I've become a fan of this little girl. And well, one of the reasons is, of course, because of who she is and the way she spoke. And I wish I had her sense of humor. But more because I come from a Muslim family, a conservative family, and from a small city of Hyderabad. At least then, when I thought of playing tennis. And I can only imagine how hard it must have been for her parents. My parents, I thought my dad, you know, is the greatest hero because he stood up against everyone and said that I don't care. They used to mock my parents and say, what do you think that your daughter is going to become Martina Hingis? And fate had it that I had to win 3 of my Grand Slams with Martina Hingis. So...